that person. I just want to just explore line and color. And I stopped because I tried to be a figurative painter and it was horrible. But it was great. It was a wonderful experience and I was, got kicked out of school. But now I'm teaching there. Anyways, that's a whole other story. But it was one of the best experiences and it's sort of like, what is your skill set and what are you good at? And then take what you're good at and just run with it. And I was just spinning my wheels to something that just wasn't working. But it was a great learning experience.
Other questions?
I was going to
say something
about that. I think my journey to abstraction was reducing. And you wouldn't know that.
By looking at the work.
But it was trying to pare things away so that all you had left was what was necessary to feel complete. And I don't know how to describe it other than that. But it wasn't the process of stripping away extraneous marks, materials, the paper, finally, and kind of minimalist approach.
I sort of think of the abstract forms in the paint and the materials in the paper as real as anything else. As real as a chair. So I don't really think of it as being something that's not there, you know. Uh-huh. So it's more I'm playing with these real things all day, these squats.
Yeah.
Your cuisinier room.
I'd like to echo that as well because I look at if I'm the current work is also often in stripes. And I think of each segment as a quite object like element. I think that this idea of going, of working abstractly also questions that those things that are unknown, that we can trust that journey toward what's less known and comes less easily. And I think a lot of us place ourselves there because of that. And so the zones of discomfort that we find when we're not sure if it's working, as Mel said, when we really don't like it, but often kind of a turning point where you just go, okay, there's something interesting starting to happen. Mm-hmm. And it's very helpful to work on many pieces at once because they have their own feedback loop.
Talk about a conversation.
Yeah.
And that's what you have to see here. Your own work's talking to itself.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very. And one other thing I was thinking of Nancy's work is her work always has reminded me of kind of a close up on a St. Martin portrait or like.
Use that your next artist statement.
Well, and then you just more or less said that about the way you see your work.
And that's what he saw too. I think he saw yeah, I think that's what he saw. And for me the journey between from figures, which I did for you sculpture for a long, long time, is proportion. And I'm a huge fan of the relationship between proportional parts to the whole. And the folded and dyed stuff, which is going to be giant origamis, you know, unfolded, is about the proportion of a line to a segment to a line, or the part to a whole, which to me is about the proportion between the length of this to the length of this to the length of this to my height. You know, so it's just, and that's also architectural as well.
Yeah.
I think Palladio is like a god. But I just really feel like there are vestiges of the figure probably in all of us. I mean, a gesture. If you make a gesture, that's your body in that thing. And it may not be, you may not be doing a drawing of a body, but you're leaving a trace of your body in that way.
Really, the thing that really is the proportion.
Yeah. The thing that Mel said about how the lines, the wiggly lines, are more volumetric than the spaces between the lines. Do you see how much math there really is?
There's a lot more complicated than we think.
Yeah. in the right word may have a kind association, or it may have met multiple metaphorical things. But a poem is a distillation of what it has said.
And also, the thing that you hear poetry read, but the meaning is not the words, the sound and the rhythm. It's in all of the pieces.
Or the length of the line.
The length of the line is all of that. And I think that's the thing that I find for painting is most important.
Well, that's a lovely way to wrap things up. Very poetic. Way to wrap things up. I would just like to thank all of you. I knew that this was going to be a really easy, fun conversation because you're all not just incredibly talented artists, but very articulate and thoughtful about your work. So I appreciate you making it so easy for me, and I hope enlightening for everybody else. So thank you.
And whether you've seen it or not, I hope you go back after this to see it again. And
when
see
is it closing?
It closes on the
21st.
21st. Yeah. So you have about.
And there's a reception again this Sunday.
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Yeah. Great. Anyhow, thank you all for the reception.